So the these works of these great poets are accessible to people of all regions of India, basically, since they have been retold in different languages and so on. How has it been reflected in different art forms of India, say, be it dance, music, sculpture, or painting, or the theaters, or the film, the modern media? Could you please elaborate on that?
Certainly, with pleasure. We all know that visual media has a lot of impact, and it is always said that Natyam Bhinna Ruchir Janasya Bahudha Pyekam Samaradhanam. Kalidasa long ago spoke in his Malavikakti Mitram. So all visual and audio forms of entertainment have exploited the themes of Ramayana, Mahabharata, and the works of Kalidasa and Gunadhyaya and others. In many of our sculptures, we do find the theme. It is very unusual. Nowhere in the world we can find a detailed narrative of the epics in stone. Actualization of the events of Ramayana and Mahabharata in stone or as wall paintings or murals, it's very, very rare to find. And such things are available. Unfortunately, due to the Islamic invasion, barbaric invasion, which happened in the North India very much, and to an extent in South India, much of the temple tradition and much of the sculptural wonder and beauty has been completely massacred, and it has been reduced to dust. But in South India, fortunately, it was preserved. Even from the sculptures of Badami, in Badami Museum, we find beautiful representation of Bhagavata stories. And from Amritapura in Karnataka, we find the longest depiction of Mahabharata, Ramayana and Bhagavata. And in the Kailasnatha temple of Yellora, we find a wonderful representation of Ramayana and Mahabharata. Like that, the sculptures of Karnataka, Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh have so many illustrations of depicting the themes of Ramayana and Mahabharata. Professor Shivram Murthy, a great art historian, has produced a book itself showing how Kalidasa has been represented in art, that is visual art of sculpture and painting. Many Rajasthani, Dakhani, and then Pahadi, Kangda, and then Patchitra, Karnataka Chikani, and Tanjavur, Kalamkari, such painting traditions have borrowed many themes from Kalidasa, Vyasa, Valmiki, and even Gunadhyaya. The stories of Panchatantra have their wonderful illustrations in the sculptures of Karnataka. One archaeologist and an art historian by name Dr. Devaraj from Karnataka has produced a book on the theme of Panchatantra as seen in the sculptures of India. Like that, they represent so much. This is about past. And even in music we have. Not to speak about the contribution of great singer saints for Haridasas and Shivasharanas and other people of the Varkari Sampradaya of Maharashtra, or the Ashtachap Kavis of North India, or the tradition of Shankardeva of Assam. Everywhere we find so much of song and music leading to theatre, doing justice to the themes of Ramayana, Mahabharata, Bhagavata and others. The great singer composers like Tyagaraja, Muthuswami Dikshita, Narayana Tirtha, Kshetriya and others, they have been inspired by these great poets. Even today, we have their songs being perpetuated on the diyas. And even in the field of dance too, many dancers have done a lot of justice to that. For example, towering example is the Ramayana Palace of Kalakshetra, Tamil Nadu. And also the contribution of Dr. Padma Subramanyam. And then the contribution of Odissi art, which has depicted so beautifully the poems of Jayadeva. And not only Jayadeva, the lyrical beauty of dance has been equatable to the poetry of Kalidasa. The marvel of Tribhangi, what we see in the tradition of Odissi. Like that, we have so many aspects of dance being inspired by the works of Kalidasa. Not directly works of Kalidasa. The cultural finesse and the beauty of Shringara that has been very well enriched by these works. And hence, we have a lot to say about music and dance. And coming to modern theatre and film, and even the television, we have so many such things. The towering examples of Telugu celluloid culture, which has a great chapter in the annals of Indian filmmaking, and also in Tamil, and even in Hindi and Kannada. And also the Doordarshan contribution, starting from the Ramanand Sagar's Ramayana and B.R. Chopra's Mahabharata, and also the great epic serial of Chandra Prakash Dwivedi, Chanakya. Everything, they have so much to get from Ramayana and Mahabharata, and also the tradition of Kalidasa and Brihatkatha. These clearly show that Indian tradition has been vibrant and enlivening, and it is never exhausted and never even dreams to exhaust these aspects of Vyasa, Valmiki, Kalidasa and others.